It's such a nice balance of all the heritage, but adapted to Cambridge. I love that it's an eco-mosque. It's a nice place to gather.
I've sort of watched it from the sort of building site with boards up and overgrown hedges to the construction site to the finished article where people are here.
It's so beautiful and really peaceful here.
The engineering of it as well, and how it's been designed.
It is a kind of wow moment.
It's for the 21st century.
This film follows the vision of Dr. Tim Winter, also known as Sheikh Abdul Hakim, and the journey of Shahida Rahman, whose family lived in Mill Road, Cambridge, the location of the Cambridge Central Mosque. Before 2008, it was just an idea. Now it is one of the most amazing buildings in the world. This is the story of the Cambridge Central Mosque.
So my father arrived in Cambridge in September 1957, and he came to Mill Road, and he was living here with other people from our community. So he came from East Pakistan. And this is where the community grew. They all seemed to have come to Mill Road. This is where the journey started. And my siblings and I, my three older brothers, my twin sister and I, we were born just off Mill Road. And we've seen the community grow. So in the 50s and 60s in Cambridge, there were no mosques. And Friday prayers used to be held in my father's living room in his house. And this was before I was born. So the community sort of came together and they shared that space. They shared food afterwards. So it was a nice social area for the men to come together. The first mosque was on a house in Chesterton Road. And this is where my siblings and I, we went there to learn our Arabic. We had Quranic studies there. And then it moved to Mawson Road in 1981. So that was the first mosque, I would say, in Cambridge. So my mother arrived in January 1964, and she came from Sylhet, which was in the north of East Pakistan. East Pakistan later became the independent nation of Bangladesh in December 1971, and I was born 2 days before the independence. So my mother was the first woman from Sylhet to actually arrive in Cambridge and live here. And then she saw the community grow, and she still talks about that today, how it started from the beginning and all those people who came after her, and she can still tell those stories.
Particularly during the Friday prayers, the mosque gets really full and it spills out onto the streets.
When I first came to Cambridge, I was surprised, really, because in Spain we had lots of beautiful mosque and it was lots of space for the children. And here it's like the opposite. Here it's just like there's no space for the women at all.
Since I first came to Cambridge, Muslims have been dreaming of their own mosque. The experience of having to go to different rooms in different weeks and checking your email for where is it going to be this week and that sort of thing is, I think, frustrating.
So what we decided to do was to choose a design, and we had a major international competition. And the winning entry was by Marks Barfield, the London architects that did the London Eye and a number of other landmark structures.
We've tried to take as many of people's concerns on board and how the mosque is going to be used. So we have an underground car park, there's going to be lots of spaces for bicycles, there would be education, there would be cafe, restaurant, the building would be open to the whole community.
One of the unique features of this mosque is that it will be the Western world's first substantial eco-mosque. So we have water recycling, we have the collection of rainwater, we have photovoltaic cells on the roof, so we generate some of our own electricity.
We've seen the design for it, I mean, amazing. I mean, I think, you know, once achieved, it'll be known throughout the world.
The architects David Marks and Julia Barfield won the competition to design the mosque. They come from a different cultural background, but were delighted to come together with Dr. Tim Winter to create a brand new sacred space. Julia Barfield learned a surprising fact during the design process.
There's a new book out about a year ago by Shahida Rahman called The British Mosque, and it traces the history of mosques in this country from, I think the very earliest was actually in Liverpool, but the first new mosque was actually in Woking in 1898. And I was amazed to read that my great-grandfather was actually involved as a trustee of the mosque, which I had no idea about. So it just shows that there has been this interlayering and interlinking of cultures in this country for many, many years.
I would say the most interesting aspect about this building is the eco effect of it, like the way it's been designed. It's a timber frame structure. So it's all about using renewable resources, i.e. timber is a renewable resource.
One thing we had to bear in mind when designing the cultural form of the structure was the unusually diverse community of Muslims here in Cambridge. Cambridge is obviously an English county town, but it's also a global hub, and it brings in a lot of quite sophisticated people from around the world to work in the science park, the university, the computing labs, and so forth. And as a result, we have maybe 70 or 80 different ethnicities here. So we crunched the census data to see who the Muslims of Cambridge might actually be. And it was amazing to see there's a significant Chinese Muslim community here. There's a Venezuelan Muslim community here. About 10% of Cambridge Muslims are black. About 9% of Cambridge Muslims are white. So a lot of stereotypes are, I think, shattered by the reality of this wonderfully diverse rainbow nation of Muslim worshippers in this building.
Well, I've been involved with this project for quite a few years now, especially with Abdul Hakim, the founder. And we believe, we've always thought that what we need is a really good representation of British Islam. You know, and there's no one, I think, who is more perfect for that role than Abdul Hakim, Tim Winter, you know, himself. But more than that, the expression of this mosque is, of course, as you can see, it's for the 21st century. It's the most ecologically, you know, befitting, let's say, contribution in terms of architecture as well. So it's the first really green, you know, mosque in Britain. You can get an idea from the architecture, how open and how light it is. And that, I think, is the representation of what we want to show.
Hi, my name is Guilherme, and I've been working on the Cambridge Mosque since the competition stage with David and Keith. And my role on the project was mainly to solve the geometry in three-dimensional space. We are inside the prayer hall under construction at the moment, where the dome was just placed, and it's kind of completing the space, and you can actually perceive the scale. The columns, we have 16 columns here, which I have worked on, and the patterns on the columns, they are based on the octagon. You have convex and concave octagons on this pattern, which kind of represents the pattern of life, breathing and exhaling.
From the competition stage, we worked with Professor Keith Critchlow, who was both my and David's tutor at the Architectural Association in the 1970s. So we have a long history with him. We know him very well. And he is also an eminent Islamic geometer and scholar. So he seemed the perfect person to invite to partner with us in doing the competition. And he's been very influential in determining the underlying geometry, as well as the more manifest geometry of some of the elements, like in the doors and the floor and the atrium and the ventilation panels. He's actually he's the Islamic artist, really, who's kind of put his mark on it and created these patterns from scratch, drawn all by hand.
there are octagonal features throughout the Cambridge Central Mosque, from floor to sky and through the wooden tree columns. Where the trees meet, you can see the wonderful geometric patterns.
So after I was appointed as a trustee in 2017, and I was invited to visit a number of times to see how the mosque was being developed, and I did see the most interesting part is seeing the dome being crowned in the mosque. I still have footage of that on my phone, and that was really amazing to see from a distance for that moment. I think that would be the highlight of seeing this mosque being built, and it was just wonderful to be part of that.
So today we're actually marking roughly the halfway point of what I think is really one of the most exciting construction projects happening at the moment in the UK. As you can see, this is the main prayer hall of the new Cambridge Mosque, and you get a good sense of the spirit of the building, the interesting combination of very modern spirit and very up-to-date cutting technologies and construction and the fabrication of it, but at the same time a sacred space. That's been the real challenge of this, to bring together something very ancient and timeless with the very latest technologies. And now we have the space more or less intact. There's no carpet, there's no lighting as yet. We really get the sense of what a great building this is, and everybody in the local community is so excited that we've reached this point.
Having looked a little bit scrappy for several months, we've actually got most of our bricks in place, and you can see that it's the traditional Cambridge gaunt brick, so hopefully we'll meld nicely with the surrounding Victorian terraces. And you can see also this amazing pattern, which is a mixture of the Victorian sort of railway architecture technique for mixing gaunt and red brick, which characterises the architecture of much of this part of Cambridge, but also hidden in these patterns are verses from the Quran. So those whose Arabic is up to scratch can actually look at the building and can read it in this kind of rectilinear form, perfectly legible and grammatically correct. So it's a building that you can actually read as you look at it, which is a tradition in many parts of the Muslim world, particularly in Central Asia, Uzbekistan and so forth, where they also use brick a lot.
Very privileged to work on it. It's a one-of-a-kind project in the UK. I've never worked on any building that looks like it or was built in this way before, so the only other building in the world that's remotely like this is in South Korea. 2016 we broke ground, we demolished all the old floor slabs and we commenced digging the basement. 2017 we started piling, and then in early spring we started the concrete works. That brought us up to end of the summer 2017, started erecting this timber frame that we have. So we need to start wrapping up the brick cladding. The tiling is ongoing, the fine secondary fixed joinery is going on, the oak panelling, the fixed furniture, the shoe racks, everything that you see inside. We're installing our toilet cubicles. Electrical and mechanical works are being second fixed. Pretty soon we'll be commencing the carpeting and the marble floor into the atrium. External works has started for the Islamic garden and the main boundary fencing and that. The dome, it's an onion-style dome. Structurally, it's made of timber. It was shipped from Switzerland and erected on the ground. We have underground car parking for 76 cars, charging points for disability scooters and electric cars, parking for bicycles, well over 100 bicycles. The mosque itself will hold 1,000 worshippers at any one time. I think it's a running theme in the project that they want people from all backgrounds to be able to come in and enjoy the space. The panels, not only are they decorative, they're concealing ventilation louvers, air intake louvers and dampers that'll work to keep the building cool in hot weather. The building's heat is sourced from the air. We have air-sourced heat pumps. They source the heat out of the air for warming up the water, and then that's pumped through the underfloor heating system. In summertime, when it's too hot, then it can also reverse and pump cold water. We have rainwater recovery system so that it will reduce any overheads and costs.
The history is that the charity first purchased the land. Those funds came from the Middle East. After having bought the land, we then went on a freeze to raise further funds to actually design the mosque and what would go on the site and involve the community. So overall, we think we'll be coming in just for the build cost of around about 23 million.
I think even though the basic purpose of the mosque is quite functional, to provide the growing Muslim community of Cambridge, which comes from around the world, Cambridge is this great global magnet, with a place to pray that keeps them out of the rain and doesn't cause traffic congestion. So we had to take some interesting cultural decisions about what we wanted the building to say, not just to Muslim worshippers, but also to the wider, often quite urbane and critical, educated environment of modern Cambridge.
To see completion day for the day that is going to open, it'll be an amazing day, an amazing time for us all. And it's really expanding on that, and for the whole community to enjoy, to come here, to come and pray, for the wider community to come and have a look at the premises, to see how this building is and how it's shaped up. We've had a lot of interest, a wide interest, from people all over the world, and we'd like to invite them to come and see and come and enjoy this place.
Well, Cambridge has some acts which are quite hard to beat, really. I mean, if we're competing with King's College Chapel and Clare College and the wonders of Cambridge, we've got our work cut out. But I think this is going to be one of the most remarkable buildings to have gone up in Cambridge in the last 200 or 300 years. It's already attracting a lot of attention. The fact that it's full of these sustainable technologies, that it's a facility for local communities generally, not just for Muslim worshippers, has attracted people's attention. And I think that, yes, in this perhaps slightly downbeat or less glamorous end of Mill Road, we're going to create maybe a new destination for those double-decker tourist buses. Because I think this is going to be a symbol of Cambridge, not just as a sort of wonderful piece of English picture postcard tourism, but is going to be an emblem of the way in which Cambridge is a pluralistic city, a multi-ethnic city, a global city, but also looking to the future rather than just being proud of the past.
It's a very a strong message we want to get across. It's for the wider community, it's for everyone to enjoy, and it's a very iconic and unique building, and I'm sure we're going to have visitors from all over the world to actually come and see this, and it's very central to Cambridge, so it's a very, very exciting project.
Train, take this country, come take me home again, 'cause I've been smiling lately.
I met Sheikh Abdul Hakim Murad when I came to Cambridge University for my graduate studies under Dr. Hersha Smith Fellowship, and it was a time as everyone, we were all searching to explore our tradition, rethink it in different contexts, and connect with Islam spiritually and intellectually. There is settled families here who have been here, but also there are students who keep coming and going, and so the demographics of the community keeps changing. So we needed a really dynamic mosque here, which could cater towards the practical, spiritual, but also intellectual needs of this very, very diverse community.
It's such a good balance of Muslim and British culture. It's something that's been missing for so many decades, considering we've had Islam as an integral part of Britain for so long. It's amazing it's taken us this long to have a properly British Muslim mosque, but it's such a nice balance of all the heritage, but adapted to Cambridge. I love that it's an eco-mosque. It's a nice place to gather, and it's just nice from an aesthetic point of view as well. So,
and I think as a young Muslim, and all of us have intellectual and spiritual needs in this modern world, and we're hoping that this mosque is gonna move beyond just being a practical place for people to come together and pray. But it's just going to be an intellectual center for the Muslims all over Europe and all over the Western countries.
The Cambridge Central Mosque, as well as being a modern sacred space, is also a very practical space for everyday community gatherings and living, in that it includes a kitchen, living quarters for the imam, areas for ablution, and not least a wonderful garden. The mosque is a centre for all aspects of life, from birth through marriage and death, and also features a morgue.
It's amazing. It really is, yeah. I mean, it is a kind of wow moment. I mean, I've been anticipating the completion of this mosque for quite some time, ever since I first saw the drawings of it, and I interviewed the architects. And I learned about all the connections between the architecture of the building and sort of the relationship to Islamic history and culture that they were really trying to sort of imbue into this, into the design. I do believe that this mosque is the most significant Muslim architectural building since Regent's Park Mosque, which was built 45 years ago. So it's a huge milestone. So it's an incredible feat of just organisation and, you know, planning and just an achievement, really. So.
So the mosque was inaugurated in December 2019, and it was everyone who was part of the build right from the start who came together to celebrate the opening. And it was wonderful to see from people all over the world, you know, to come together and to celebrate that day with us.
The Cambridge Mosque was officially opened by Turkish President Erdogan in a visit in December 2019.
From conception to completion, this mosque was more than 10 years in the making. It was funded by donations from 10,000 people and organisations. Three quarters of them came from Turkey.
We have gathered in Cambridge not only to open a mosque, but also to highlight that all the pieces of the mosque refer to a unity and oneness that we seek. And this is a gift for this beautiful city.
For me, it is an absolute honor to be part of this project. To be one of the main imams to this mosque is beyond my imagination. It's a huge responsibility, but I'm very happy that I managed to come here, and I'm really happy that God gave me this opportunity to serve my people and the community. The imam's role is not like any other role, you could argue. It's touching upon every single segment of our society. It's a public role in a way. It's a leading a faith community, being responsible about our younger and older generations, teaching them, guiding them about our religion, Islam, outreaching to the wider community. It is a mixed role, but it's a very big responsibility, because our job is to narrate the intentions that God Almighty sent down through his messengers to guide mankind, to make us better human beings as a whole. So it's a very, very demanding job, but at the same time, if you know the value of this particular work, you will do it with the utmost delight. This mosque is quite unique. It has many innovative features in the building, in the architecture of this place.
So we go in through the gates, and there's a fountain, because water, of course, is the most important element in an Islamic garden. And then you can walk either to the left or to the right to get out of the main thoroughfare, because anyone can come in through here. And if you want to, if you're with children or on your own, you can walk to the left or right, and there are places for sitting. So it's a kind of quiet, hopefully contemplative space before going into the mosque to pray, or before going in, there's also a cafe area. So it's very much open to all. I mean, Abdul Hakim Winter, who's really the master behind everything to do with the Cambridge Mosque, he wanted it to be very open to anyone who's passing, not just Muslims who want to come and pray, but people who want to come in and have coffee maybe, or just also to see the mosque and to go in and pray quietly, not necessarily pray Salat or one of the ritual prayers, but it's very much something for the community.
For the first time, a mosque has won the Reba Stirling Prize People's Vote, a public poll run by the Royal Institute of British Architects.
It's a fantastic achievement for the community and city, and it demonstrates what can happen when communities and cultures work together for a common purpose. The CAA congratulates Cambridge Central Mosque and Mark Spartfield Architects for creating a truly world-class building for their community.
When this mosque was built and opened in 2019, we've seen so many people come here from all over the UK just to visit the beautiful building that we have here.
I think it's extraordinary. I think it's a marvellous design, and it's it's a huge addition, I think, to Cambridge. And it's just to have to marvel at the engineering of it as well, and how it's been designed, and how it's designed to basically take the whole force of the roof as well.
For me, it's my local mosque. It's a place of prayer. It's also a place for other people to come and visit and to find out more about Islam and find out more about who we are as Muslims. And that's what I would like to do, is continue that dialogue and continue that conversation.
So 2008 is when the land was purchased, and my earliest memories were I was going into secondary school at that point, and sort of the bucket campaign of collecting sort of pennies and buying a brick and whatnot to set up. And then it's sort of 2012, planning permission got approved. That's when I was getting my GCSEs done. 2017, by the time construction finally started, I was in university. In 2019, when it finally completed, I was graduating and then being asked to come and set up this tours program and an ability to open up the mosque for everyone at all times. And then since then, there's been about 7,000 people that have gone on this sort of transformative tour experience. And it's one of the most popular services offered here at Cambridge Central Mosque. Grown up with it, and I actually live just on the next road, so I've sort of watched it from the sort of building site with boards up and overgrown hedges to the construction site to the finished article where people are here on a Friday with thousands of people visiting every week. On days like today, probably about half the people here have come in from outside of Cambridge. It's the summer holidays right now. We've got visitors from all around the world that say, I've come to Cambridge specifically to see this mosque. So I think the mosque building has now sort of created a new attraction into Cambridge. It was already a very sort of tourist-heavy area with all the university buildings, etc. But now the Cambridge Central Mosque just attracts even more visitors here, and I'm really proud to be part of that, a small part of that.
So many young people love coming here. Every time I come here, there's always one child just running about and absolutely loves the environment and the atmosphere here. So it's a place for all, definitely.
Last month in August, we did gala dinner for fundraising for Cambridge Central Mosque and community outreach project. And our campaign started about 9 months ago, is a begin. Then we thought, how we're going to make it everybody together, because this is the first eco-friendly masjid, and that is, we said, eco-challenge as a planted tree. And helping to the our is a climate change part of the campaign to the planted tree to help the environment.
Of course, there have been challenges, not least a global pandemic.
So the mosque closed when the pandemic hit in March 2020. So the mosque was open for 1 year and then we had to close. And it was a very difficult time for people who are used to coming here, as a visit to the mosque was part of their everyday life. And everything had to move online. So it was connecting with a new audience in a different way. And I think to this day, we are still doing that and reaching an audience all over the world. But to see new people visiting, and particularly women as well, seeing more women actually come and pray in our mosque where we've not seen before in Cambridge. And I think that's a really good example of our mosque, is it's open for all.
So do you remember when the mosque went into lockdown and how we were all feeling at the time?
Yeah, it wasn't a great time really. We had so many visitors coming to the mosque and then it all just stopped really. Mm-hmm. And even when lockdown was lifted, we still had to restrict the number of people coming, didn't we?
It seemed really odd taking everything online. That's what happened then. So it's been more than 2 years, but do you remember the vaccine clinic? What happened then?
Yeah, I remember when we spoke to some of the clinicians in the city, and they were saying that, you know, the vaccine take up in our community was quite low. And then we felt we've got to do something for the local effort with increasing the number of people that were taking the vaccines. And I think the vaccine pop-up station in the mosque led to that, didn't it?
I think it was good for our mosque to deliver that service to the community. And that's what we're recognised for, as the outreach work that we're doing is catering for all members of the community.
You can get an idea from the architecture, how open and how light it is. And that, I think, is the representation of what we want to show. The point about Abdul Hakim is that he keeps his doors very wide open. And so therefore, I believe there'll be a lot of interaction, a lot of educational value, lectures and so many. If you just go on YouTube, you'll be able to see how Abdul Hakim talks about every single issue. And so it's a very wide, panorama for anybody to be invited to come and enjoy.
Yes, I've been smiling lately, dreaming about the world as one, and I believe it could be someday it's going to come. 'Cause out on the edge of darkness, there rides a peace train. Oh, peace train, take this country, come take me home again. 'Cause I've been smiling lately, thinking about the good things to come, and I believe it could be something good has begun. Oh, peace train sounding louder, glide on the peace train. Come on, peace train. Yes, peace train, holy roller. Everyone jump up on the peace train. Come on, peace train.
So I know we've been here hundreds of times, but how does the mosque make you feel every time you come?
I think for me it's a place of peace. We can get away from our busy lives and come here as a place of reflection. So I always feel at peace, and it's just a nice place for us to reflect on what we're doing every day. You know, sometimes we do forget what this mosque is about. It's a place of worship, and this is why we're here.
When the mosque was being built, you've seen it right from the start. I mean, I get the impression when I come here, it seems very different every day that I come, depending on the weather, the conditions, the lighting. Do you get that sense as well, that it still challenges you every day when you come here?
I think every day when I come here, I feel blessed to be part of the mosque. And I'm always thinking of, for me to have that involvement here, I just feel very blessed. And it's a true meaning of my life that this is a big part of my life, and it's just nice coming here and just a place of peace. That's what I would say.
Well, in a sense, we've done the easy bit. The builders were easier to deal with than the long-term fundraising and dealing with the congregation, people's marriages, divorces, the issues of the human race. So we have a very strong pastoral responsibility, because there are issues in the community of relationships failing, of addiction, of unemployment, of poverty, of income disparity, of people with depression, anxiety, illnesses of various kinds, bereavement, and a place of worship. If it's really a place of worship, it has to be a kind of hospital for all of those people, rather than just a place where we line up five times a day and say our prayers.
It started as a small community and a small community mosque around Mill Road in Cambridge. Now it is something truly global, but still local and still very much at the heart of the community.
I mean, it's a fantastic and amazing new addition to Mill Road, but also it means a lot to Muslims and non-Muslims from much further afield than Mill Road as well. So the Cambridge population of Muslims and the surrounding areas populates about 10,000 people right now. And the previous mosque that we had on Mill Road, 500 people, 300 people. So really there was a massive need for a purpose-built mosque in Cambridge. And when this site came up for purchase, it just seemed like the perfect fit, and adds really well to the sort of culture that we've cultivated here on Mill Road. So we've now got a purpose-built space. It's fit for the community, it's fit for the wider community as well, and creates fantastic spaces like this for people like you and I to come and talk. Well, I've been very lucky to be part of this project from sort of inception. It's spanned my childhood, I live just around the corner, 2 minutes walk away, but every time I come here, I'm able to come here daily. But when I step foot inside, a sort of a sense of calmness sort of comes about me, and I'm able to sort of detach from the outside world and really immerse myself in the beauty of the space, and also the calmness and serenity that invokes inside myself.
So I think there are very few East Pakistani men who actually came in the 40s in Cambridge, and then their families started to come over in the 1960s and 70s, and that's where we saw the community grow. So I think the Bangladeshi community is probably the biggest ethnic minority community in Cambridge, I would say.
I remember when we were growing up in the 70s, we only used to see Bangladeshi men predominantly. I think the Bangladeshi community was the largest community at the time, and then it started to become more diverse. Mm-hmm. I think for the younger generation, the mosque is a norm. For us, we never really expected to have a building like this, so I guess they're going to be the custodians, and they're the ones that are going to have to look after it and run it in the future. And because it's sustainable and it's eco, I think that's also become the norm, and I think that's really good to see too.
There's a buzz in the world tonight. People are so excited. Daddy's coming home soon, hoping to see the moon, hoping to catch a sight. Everyone's so happy. Moon, moon, come out soon. We're off to see the Ramadan moon. Cloud shift, fog lift, city put out your lights. We want to see the Ramadan moon tonight.
See it.
Oh wow, so can I.
Tomorrow.